Benny, Agneta, Anna Fried, and Bjorn were known for their harmonies, their flamboyant outfits, and for the deep emotional connection of their songs. But for many, their biggest legacy is...
they just made you want to get up and dance.
And even though the four original members of the supergroup ABBA haven't performed officially live for over 40 years, they're now back to make us dance again, with what will be a revolutionary concert with a difference and some brand new music.
And I've been lucky enough to secure an exclusive interview with the men behind the songs.
Benny Andersson and Bjorn Ulvaeus.
What is it like, the four of you together, working and recording new music?
It was great, and it was kind of a familiar situation from the word go.
Yeah. It started with asking them if they wanted to come in and sing a couple of songs, because we have this concert taking place next year here in London. And they said yes. And from that moment, I'd say, everything became bright. And I was thinking, just before they came to the studio, I said, I haven't asked them if they still can sing.
You know, well, that moment when the two of them went into the studio and sang together, and that unique sound that only they can produce came out.
And the
four of us still being able to work together because we wanted to.
Now it was wonderful.
I still have faith in you. I see it now. All these years that
song. I still have faith in
you. Yes, that's the first one we started with. Yeah.
That's the single coming out now.
There was a union of heart and mind.
And then we ended up with an album.
Called Voyage. And a voyage it is.
I mean, it's a long journey. We're talking about decades.
Yeah. It's a well-known saying in the music industry that you shouldn't leave more than 40 years between albums.
Yeah. You've got that just in the nick of time.
Just in the nick of time.
There's no chance to sort of try to dive into what's going on in the music world today. So I'd say what we did is we just continued where we stopped. The only thing you can do is, do I like this or don't I? If I like it, then, well, we'll keep it.
How exactly are you bringing yourselves to the stage in the new concert?
We are digitally projected, but it's not holograms.
We did something called motion capture, and there we put on some kind of leotard with dots on it, and we did the songs on a stage.
There were 100 guys there with the computers.
They are now becoming so much alive.
They could choose, what year do you want to be?
Yeah.
And, they picked the year when the hair was good.
It's an arena for 3,000 people, half standing, half sitting.
We'll have a live band, so it will be a live concert.
And light everywhere. As an audience, you're in something which we hope will be
good.
Totally new experience.
Yeah.
We are kind of pioneers in this.
Why did you choose the UK?
It was the obvious choice. The Brits, for some reason, have always seen us as their own, almost.
I think we love you the most. What's the
name of the game? Interesting thing is that we're still existing. We go out on the street and you can hear someone playing ABBA song. I don't get that.
I can explain it.
Oh!
Yeah,
because nobody has so far.
It's really simple. I can hum your songs the first time I hear them, but I have to keep going back to listen to them because there's so much complexity built in. And I don't know how you do that. I think it's a miracle, genuinely.
No, that's nice. Well, thank you.
I have to say thank you for the music. I'm not the first to say that.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
But no one's ever meant it more, so thank you.
Thank you very much.
Pleasure being here. Do I have it in?